The time is now. Kenta versus Jon Moxley for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship here on New Japan Strong.
Kenta suplexes Moxley on the floor.
Knee pad down, the exposed knee. Moxley's Death Rider finish, but you gotta be watch out for this. A spare table underneath the ring. Just smashed him in the head with the U.S. title belt. Oh no.
He's looking to do some real damage. A big elbow drop, breaking that table in half.
Might have broken Jon Moxley in half. And now Kenta drives the knee to the back of Moxley's head.
Kenta with closed eyes slaps.
Wait a minute. Transition. Wait a minute, Death Rider.
He did it.
Jon Moxley victorious.
It may have been the new beginning in the USA, but it was an event that ended with the words, "and still." I'm Chris Charlton, and this is Finish Strong for the week of February the 26th, 2021. The world had been talking about Jon Moxley versus Kenta for the US Championship for months, and the end result certainly lived up to the hype. But there was plenty more action on NJPW Strong this week, starting with an 8-man tag team bout as the DKC, Clark Connors, Kevin Knight, and TJP took on Brody King, ACH, and Logan and Sterling Regal. After Brody King declared that he had ideas in mind for himself and his teammates, his crew of four headed to the ring tonight with a unified vision and a vicious approach in the ring. ACH took over at the start on DKC, and then the Regals took the fight to TJP before the Philand Flash was able to do what he does best. King then came in to bring the violence to Kevin Knight, running through the young lion and giving control to his team before Knight was able to slam Sterling Regal to get back in the fight. A Connors spear landed on ACH, but as the match broke down, it was a vertical drop brainbuster from ACH to the DKC to give the win to him and his team. After a chaotic post-match beatdown in a tag team main event a couple of weeks ago on NJPW Strong, Ren Narita took on Chris Dickinson this week. The undefeated Dirty Daddy continues to try and prove himself in the Cerulean Blue, and after an exchange of holds on the mat gave neither man the upper hand, a chop exchange left both men with reddened chests. The larger Dickinson was able to lock Narita into the STF, forcing Narita to the ropes, and although Narita was able to fire back, Dickinson was able to take advantage by isolating the leg of the LA Dojo member. Ren Narita fired up and landed some stiff corner shots before being cut off by a DVD, yet Narita's tenacity and persistency paid off with a Narita special number 3 for the submission win as Ren Narita continues his impressive rise. Yet tonight was all about the IWGP United States Heavyweight Championship and Mox versus Kenta. With the time for talk long past, this match started with a high pace, and after throwing bombs, it was the US champion with the upper hand driving Kenta to the ropes. Kenta couldn't find an opening in the ring, but a suplex on the floor and a DDT on that red briefcase certainly shifted favor to the challenger. Now in his wheelhouse, Kenta landed stinging kicks and blows from a rear mount to the champion. Kenta had a clear edge in the stand-up game, but knowing he had to go big or go home without his title, Mox decided to go big with a tope suicida and a big knee off the staging area. The referee let both men fight as Moxley set up a table at ringside, but after a belt shot and a huge elbow, it was Moxley going through that furniture. A corner-to-corner dropkick and a double stomp, but Moxley was still alive, instinctively firing out a German suplex and a wild lariat. Kenta locked in the game over, but there was no quit in the US champion as Moxley made the ropes. And as both champion and challenger were damaged, fatigued, and desperate. Each looked for the killing blow. Moxley was able to stop the go-to-sleep and landed the Death Rider, and although Kenta refused to stay down at the first time of asking, the second attempt at the hold got the three. John Moxley is indeed still the IWGP United States Heavyweight Champion, and it truly feels that this is a new beginning for the US title and for NJPW Strong at large.
I love doing it in New Japan Pro Wrestling. Like I said earlier, I don't see red lights and yellow lights in life. I choose not to, I just focus on green lights. I go when I want, how I want, do it how I want to do it. Until somebody takes me out. I am the baddest son of a bitch and number one man in this game.
What is next for NJPW Strong? Major announcements are incoming. Stay tuned to NJPW1972.com for huge news very, very soon. And speaking of huge, major action continues in Japan as well. On March the 4th, we celebrate 49 years of the King of Sports at a huge anniversary event at the Nippon Budokan. Then it is the start of the Ultimate Spring Tournament, New Japan Cup 2021. All of the action is live on NJPWWorld.com. That's it. We've finished strong for another week. Until next time, gokigenyo. Sayonara.